Silkworm rearing appliances. Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about silkworm rearing appliances. Introduction. Sericulture is a rural based agro industry, and accordingly the appliances used are made from cheap and locally available materials. Hence, the appliances differ from place to place and also according to the system of rearing and system of mulberry harvest. With sericulture spreading to many non-traditional states and with the launching of National Sericulture Project, that is NSP, many innovations have been carried out by the researchers of the CSB and other institutions, and also by private rearers in developing novel rearing appliances to suit the conditions in India. The most common method of rearing in India is the traditional shelf rearing method, as it is facilitate the rearing of large number of worms in a small place and improved shoot rearing racks, which saves 50% labor in large scale rearing. The appliances used for this method of rearing are: A. Appliances used for keeping the worms being reared, that is rearing stand. The silkworms are reared circular or rectangular trays stocked one above the other in vertical rows on a rearing shelf or stand. In general, it is made up of locally available wood or bamboo for making the stand as well as the trays. The large cooperative rearing steel slotted angles are used for the shelf. The standard sized stand has a height of 2.5 meter, length of 1.5 meter and a width of 0.65 meter. It has 10 to 12 crossbars at a distance of 0.15 meter to accommodate 10 to 12 tires of rearing trays. Tray rearing is practiced in non-traditional areas by few farmers. A large number of silkworms accommodated in and fed in the rearing trays, and these are placed one above the other in the rearing stand. Circular bamboo trays 138 centimeter diameter into 6.5 centimeter depth are the most commonly used in India. Rectangular wooden trays similar to ones used for rearing chunky worms are also used. Young silkworms are reared in rectangular trays made up of wood, that is 0.7 to 0.9 meter into 0.9 to 1.2 meter. The bamboo trays are used mostly after coating them with cow dung paste mixed with formalin to lengthen the lifetime, but such practice has been proved to increase disease incidence. Shoot rearing rack. To bring down labor cost and increase the productivity, shoot feeding method of rearing has been developed and standardized for tropical conditions. Shoot rearing racks are constructed, fabricated. The rack should be 5 to 6 feet width and length as long as the rearing hall. The rearing rack can have 3 to 4 tires with a gap of 2.5 to 3 feet between the racks for effective aeration. Fabricate the rack stand with wood or steel and rearing seat with wire mesh or nylon wires and twills. These are placed below the legs of the rearing stand and are filled with water to prevent ants from crawling up the stand and harming the silkworms. Enamel or aluminum trays are convenient size or sufficient for this purpose. Standard ant wells are concrete or stone blocks of 20 centimeter square and 7.5 centimeter height with a groove of 2.5 centimeter running all around the top. Water is poured in the groove of the ant well to prevent the climbing of ants to the stand. Oozy nets. Oozy flies enter the rearing through windows and doors to lay their eggs on the bodies of the worms, the most preferred stages being the 3rd, 4th, and 5th instars and the spinning worms. To preclude their reaching the worms, nets similar to mosquito nets are used, made of nylon. Formerly, the nets were affixed to the windows and doors. B. Appliances needed for disinfection. Normally, bleaching powder solution and other room disinfectants, namely Astra, Sanitec, Decal, etc., are used for disinfection. Sprayer for disinfection. A sprayer, either hand operated or power operated, is needed for effective disinfection of rearing house and equipments prior to rearing operations. They are knapsack pack sprayer, gutter rocking sprayer, electric motor operated sprayers, kerosene or petrol operated power sprayers. C. Appliances used for chakki rearing. Loose egg incubation frames. The plastic base frame is 29 cm into 24 cm and 2 cm in thickness and 1.5 cm groove is around the box frame to fit the gripper frame. Base frame has 17 into 14 cm length and width with 1.5 cm and 1.5 cm grooves. Paraffin paper. Thick craft paper coated with paraffin wax 55 degree centigrade melting point is used to prevent evaporation of moisture and to maintain high humidity in the rearing bed of the young silkworm. As this paper is not locally available in the villages, alternatives such as polythene sheets are also used successfully. Foam pads. These are also used to maintain high humidity in the bed of young worms. Longitudinal strips of 2.5 cm width and 2.5 cm thick foam pads soaked in water are placed all around the bed of young worms. However, use of foam pads are discontinued nowadays after popularization of commercial CRCs and equipments. Chopsticks. These are two thin sticks of bamboo 17.5 cm or 20 cm which taper to a point. At the thick end, the two are connected by a small thread and these sticks are used like a forceps for picking worms, particularly disease worms, away from the bed and spreading chakki rearing bed for drying. Feather. Bird feathers, preferably white ones, are used for brushing newly hatched larvae from the egg cord to the rearing trays and to spread the young worms during the spacing operation after disinfection. Doormats and wash basin to exclude germ entry into the room along with the rearing personnel. It is mandatory that all the persons entering the room not only leave their outdoor footwear outside the room but also wipe their feet on a doormat soaked with disinfectant. As an additional precaution, they are required to wash their hands in a disinfectant solution kept in a wash basin before handling the worms. Dettol, Shuchi solutions are used for hand wash in place of formalin solution. Leaf baskets. These are bamboo baskets of convenient size used for collecting, transporting the mulberry leaves from the field to the rearing house. During the transport of leaves in these baskets, there is some inevitable loss of water from the leaves. Wet gunny bags were substituted for leaf baskets to overcome the defect. Plastic containers or buckets are used for chakki leaf harvest. Leaf chamber. The sides and bottom of the chamber are made up of strips of wooden reapers, is used to store harvested mulberry leaf. Wet gunny cloth is placed has a lining on all side and top. Water is sprinkled periodically on the gunny cloth to keep the leaves fresh inside the chamber for long duration. Chopping board. This is a rectangular board made up of soft wood used for cutting chalky mulberry leaf to the desired size. Chopping knife. Sickle like knives with broad and sharp blade are needed for chopping mulberry leaves prior to feeding larva. The knives should be good quality. They should not have any nicks but must have a sharp edge to effect a neat cut without any splits. Splits increase the area of the cut edges and increase rate of evaporation from the leaves. Leaf chopping machines. Different types of manual and motorized chopping machines are designed at CSRT Mysore for chopping of mulberry chalky leaf into the different sizes for different age of silkworms. Mats. These are placed below the chopping board prior to chopping and used to collect the cut leaves. Disinfected polyvinyl sheets are also used. Feeding stand. A folding stand on which the trays removed from the stand are placed one at a time for feeding and bed cleaning. A lot of new models of different heights, adjustable heights and revolving types have been introduced in the field. Tray washing machine. A large number of plastic trays are to be washed in a chalky rearing center. A tray washing machine developed at CSRT Mysore can clean and wash 60 to 70 trays per hour. The machine highly useful for chalky rearing centers. D. Appliances needed for maintaining optimum environmental conditions. Hygrometer. Humidity in the room controls evaporation of water from the leaves as well as from the worms. Young age worms require a higher humidity 80 to 85% than late age worms 70 to 75%. Too low humidity drives the leaves and render them unpalatable for the worms, and too high humidity favors growth of fungal pathogens. Hence, it is necessary to maintain optimal humidity. A hygrometer is used to measure the humidity of the room and to make appropriate adjustment until optimal humidity is achieved. Digital and dial hygrometers are commonly used to measure the humidity. Humidifier. A humidifier is an apparatus used to maintain the desired humidity and is electrically operated. Thermometer. Digital and mercury thermometers are commonly used to measure the temperature of the rearing house. Heating and cooling devices. Thermostatic heaters and air conditioners help to maintain temperature. Hanging a wet cloth, spreading wet sand and increasing ventilation are some means for lowering temperature. Electric heaters, charcoal stoves are used to increase the temperature to optimum level. Air circulation devices. Traditional farmers use no aeration devices, but large modernized silkworm rearing houses handling a huge volume of silkworms use electrically operated fans or other air circulation devices to maintain sufficient ventilation. Exhaust fans and industrial exhaust fans are used for air circulation effectively in large scale rearing house. E. Appliances used for bed cleaning. Nets. Nets of different mesh size made of cotton or nylon thread are placed above the trays on which fresh mulberry leaves are sprinkled, enable the silkworms crawl from the old bed which can be cleaned. The mesh size should be the square of length of the larval's instar. If the holes are small, they cannot crawl through them and if they are too large, the worms crawling up once again fall back to the original bed. F. Appliances used to support the spinning larvae. The contrivance used for supporting the larvae when they are spin their cocoons is called cocoonage or mountage. This is a most important appliance in the sericulture as it determines both the quality and quantity of good cocoons harvested and their reeling performance. The mountage should be such that the worms are able to spin their cocoon comfortably and to their full potential. Harvesting the cocoons from mountage done easily without any damage to the cocoons. Different types of mountages are used in different parts of India and in other countries. They are made up of wood, bamboo, cardboard, plastic, etc. While constructing the mountage, proper attention should be given to the manner in which the worms spin their cocoons and to their requirements for space, air, ventilation, temperature and humidity. An ideal mountage should satisfy the following requirements. 1. Provide convenient space of suitable dimension for spinning good size cocoons. Should not promote the formation of double cocoons or malformed cocoons and flimsy cocoons. Should have provisions for the drying up of the lost urine and excreta passed by the silkworms prior to spinning and prevention of this excreta falling on the cocoon of other worms. Should be suitable for easy mounting and harvesting. Should be cheaper, durable, easy to handle, easy to available, occupy less space and allow free flow air. Precautions. In addition to the maintenance of required temperature, that is 25 degree centigrade, humidity 60 to 65%, cross ventilation and uniform illumination in the mounting place. Do not expose mountages to direct sunlight during or after spinning. This is very important especially during rainy season because the reliability drastically affected leading to lower cocoon price. Allow cross ventilation in mounting place. Avoid storing mountages in the rearing house premises. Mountages are commonly used in India. Several types of mountages are available for cocoon spinning. However, at field level, the following three types of mountages are predominantly used. Number 1, bamboo chandrike. Number 2, plastic collapsible mountages. Number 3, rotary mountages. Number 1, bamboo chandrike. Bamboo chandrike are the traditional and the most commonly used appliances which cover more than 90% of the sericulture farmers. The mature silkworms are picked up manually from the rearing bed and then distributed in the spiral grooves of the chandrike where they spin their cocoons. Chandrike is bamboo spiral mountage is the most popular in South India and West Bengal and its use has spread to other parts of India also. This consists of bamboo mat of size 1.8 meter into 1.2 meter supported by split bamboo reapers on all sides. On this bamboo mat, a bamboo tape of 4 to 5 centimeter width is wound in a spiral manner. The bamboo tape has V-shaped struts supported by three long bamboo strips. About 1000 worms can be mounted on this mountage. Always keep the mountage in vertical or semi-vertical position. Never pile up the mountage horizontally one over the other. Maintain at least 12 inches gap between the mountages. Due to intensive bamboo industry in different parts of country, the availability of bamboo chandrike has become easy and accessible to the farmers. due to the simplicity of appliances and the procedure involved in the usage of bamboo chandrike have become the most popular appliance for cocoon spinning. Some farmers possess their own chandrike and the other will get them on higher basis. In recent years, community mountingals have also come up in different villages where sericulture is intense. However, these bamboo chandrikes are replaced with plastic collapsible mountages to maximum extent recently. Advantages of chandrikes are they are made from cheap locally available materials, they are easy to handle, they are easy to mount and harvest. The disadvantages are they are extremely expensive and rental cost is also very high. Moreover, now bamboo itself is a protected plant in the forest and this makes it rare and costly. They are prone to damage from the rodents and ants and are easily damaged during handling. They cannot be thoroughly disinfected before and after spinning. They require a lot of area both for mounting of worms and storage when they are not in use because they cannot be stocked one above the other which will destroy the flowers. They are not suitable for indoor spinning and when outdoor spinning is done on them. It exposes the worms to the natural enemies and pathogens. If the spiral tape or flower is not stitched properly, giving specified space between the rows, there is waste of space on the chandrike. Its large size and heavy weight pose problem in handling as well as in storing. Harvesting and cleaning are time consuming. Occurrence of stained cocoons is more in chandrike. Number 2, plastic collapsible mountages. The mountages consist of plastic mesh bent into 11 uniform folds of about 6 cm height attaining longitudinal furrows throughout their width. These grooves act as sites for formation of cocoons by the matured silkworms. The ideal size of the mountage should be 60 into 90 cm. Mountages of different sizes are available in market. Plastic collapsible mountages are used mainly as self-mounting device to save labor during spinning. They are preferred by large-scale farmers to avoid labor constraints. For self-mounting, the mountages are spread on the rearing bed on a single layer or two tires with their folding being right angled to each other. Then the mature larvae will crawl onto the mountage and spin cocoons. Number 3, rotary mountage. It is an advanced scientific model developed by Japanese scientists mainly for bioltens. It consists of a frame with 10 board hives. Each board is composed of 12 sections with 13 rows, making a total of 156 chambers open at both the ends. 10 each frames are assembled on a turning wooden frame. Though 1560 cells are available in each unit, only 1250 to 1300 worms should be mounted to allow free aeration. The cocoons are more uniform with less number of defective cocoons and higher reliability and hence cocoons fetch higher rate. About 35 to 40 units are required for 100 FLS. Rotary mountages are delicate and hence they should be handled smoothly. After the cocoon harvest, the flowers on the cardboards should be burned smoothly using flame gun. After burning, they should be kept in sunlight, spray of Astra or Sanitec solution and covered with vinyl sheet for 6 hours and then sun dried. The mountages should be preserved in a safe, well ventilated place free from rats and termites. Cocoon harvester. Harvesting is usually done manually in most of the mountages used. Only with the rotary mountages is an automatic cocoon harvester used. The frames of the mountages are inserted into a machine and the pincer like attachment of the machine inserted into the each hole of the frame harvest the cocoons there. Deflossing machine. The outer layer of the cocoon consists of unreelable silk floss and has to be removed before reeling. CSRT Mysore has developed different models. Small farmers can use hand operated machines, whereas for medium and large farmers motorized deflossers can be used. The deflossing machine can help in deflossing cocoons at a very fast rate and saves labor charges. The defloss cocoons fetch higher price in market. Summary. The most common method of rearing in India is the traditional self-rearing method, as it facilitates the rearing of large number of worms in a small place and improved shoot rearing racks, which saves 50% labor in large scale rearing. The appliances used for silkworm rearing are rearing stand, shoot rearing rack, rearing trays, ant wells, paraffin paper, foam pads, chopsticks, feather, doormats and wash basin, tray washing machine, hygrometer, humidifier, thermometer, heating and cooling devices, air circulation devices, leaf basket, leaf chamber, chopping board, chopping knife, chopping machines, mats, feeding stand, nets, different types of mountages, deflossing machine, cocoon harvesters, etc. With this, we come to an end of the chapter, silkworm rearing appliances. Thank you.